So let's see an example of how you can use a spreadsheet to plan the first condition your group plans to collect data on. First, you need to decide with your group which variables you will hold constant across every data point you collect from. And you need to add that information in the green cells here. So let's say that for this example, I will use potassium. And I will test a crystal width of 40 points. Notice that as I enter that information, the first two columns are filled. Next, you need to choose a value for your independent variable, which is the percentage of barren element that you wish to collect data on for the decay of that element. So let's say that for the first test that you carry on, you will stop the simulation when the percentage of barren element is 90%. And for the second test, you will stop it at 85%. And for the third test, you will stop it at 80%. So you will see that the total of percentage of parent element plus daughter element always equals 100% for every data point that you collect. And now this group is ready to collect data on at least three different values at which the simulation will stop, and they will record this data in the purple cells. As a group, you will need to decide how many trials you will want to carry out for each data point that you measure. Notice that as you collect your data, a graph starts to build on the right side of the tables. You will use this graph later on to analyze your data. If you want to collect additional data for different conditions, use the tabs at the bottom. You will have five tabs to try five different conditions with your group.